Good morning, students. Today we will start with lesson 11, part 1, simple machine of class 5th science. It is video 11. Today we will start with chapter simple machines. Practically everything that we do require movement, like walking or lifting weight or throwing a basketball. We use muscle in these movements. These muscles have to relax and contract for the bones to move in older days. Most of the work which had to be done involved use of muscle power of domesticated animals like horses or oxen, or even human beings themselves. If we would like to go quicker than a horse can travel or pick up something extremely heavy, we use machines. Machines have been used by man for a long time. Pyramids were built and enormous stone buildings were constructed by ancient engineers who used a simple machine like pulley and levers. Nowadays, we can travel very fast by cars, trains and aeroplane. For building skyscraper, the construction engineer used tower cranes. All this involve movement irrespective of whether machines or muscle power is used. In chapter in starting, they have given unjumbled words. We have to arrange these words to form the particular word. So A, unscrambled word, it is refrigerator. B, unscrambled word, it is microwave. C, unscrambled word, it is washing machine. D, unscrambled word, it is oven. E, unscrambled word, it is geyser. We use different machine in our daily life. Machines help us to do our work faster. A machine can be defined as a tool that makes our work easier by helping us to overcome a large force by applying lesser force and effort. Underline lesser force and effort. And this is the definition of machine. These four lines are definition of machine. When you think of machine, you usually think of washing machine, aeroplane, refrigerator, car, etc. Such machines are called complex machine. They consist of two or more simple machine working together. Underline this. They consist of two or more simple machine working together. Things like punching machine, scissor, stapler, brooms are also machine. They are simple machines. Simple machines use a single force to overcome a single load. Underline single force overcome a single load. Simple machine. Simple machines make our work easier in any of the following ways. Number one, by increasing the amount of force applied, by changing the direction of the force, by increasing the speed of doing work. In this way, simple machine make our work easier. Now see in the books, by increasing the amount of force applied, by changing the direction of force applied, by increasing the speed of doing work. In this lesson, you will learn about six types of simple machine: lever, inclined plane, screw, pulley, wheel and axle. Lever. Lever is a rigid rod that can move freely around a fixed point. Lever consists of three parts: F, fulcrum; L, load; E, effort. Load, fulcrum, effort. Fulcrum, it is a fixed point around which the lever moves. It is a fixed point through which lever get the support and lever moves. Load, it is the object on which work is to be performed or that has to be moved. Load, an object on which we have to perform work to move. Effort, it is the force that has to be applied on the rod. Underline applied on the rod. In order to perform a task, effort, force has to be applied on the rod to perform a task. Which task? To pick this load from the place. Load arm. Load arm is the distance between the fulcrum and load. Distance between fulcrum and load. We call it load arm. Effort arm. Effort arm is the distance between the fulcrum and the effort. Distance between fulcrum and effort. Call it effort arm. When the lever is balanced, then effort into effort arm equal to load into load arm. Both will be equal. Based on positions of fulcrum, load and effort, levers are of three types: first class lever, second class lever and third class lever. In case of first class lever, fulcrum is in the center, load and effort on the side. In second class lever, load is in the center, effort and fulcrum is on both sides. In third class lever, effort is between fulcrum and load. First class of lever, we know fulcrum between the load and effort. In the first class lever, the fulcrum is located between the load and the effort. Underline fulcrum is located between. Examples are crowbar, a pair of scissors, a seesaw and many more examples from first class lever. See the scissor. At the center, it is fulcrum. Here at the tip which we use to cut paper or cloth, this portion load, and at the back side from which where we hold it for open and close it, this portion is the effort. It is the example of first class lever. Fulcrum is located between load and effort. Second class lever, we know load is between effort and fulcrum. In the second class of lever, the load is located between the fulcrum and effort. Underline, load is located between. A wheelbarrow, bottle opener, nut cutter are the example of second class lever. See this diagram of wheelbarrow. Here at the last, wheel is fixed where two rods are joined together, that is the fulcrum, and at the center where we put material inside it act like load. At third class of lever, in the third class lever, the effort is located between the fulcrum and the load. Underline, effort is located between. See this diagram, effort is located between. A pair of tongs, a tweezer, a stapler and a fishing rod are the example of third class lever. See this photograph of tongs and the stapler. Here fulcrum where two stripes of tongs joined together, and at the front side they shown one chapati. It is a load, act like a load, and from the center we hold it. It means we are applying effort. Similarly with the stapler, where we put the effort, which thing act like a load, and where the fulcrum. They pointed in the diagram in which you come to know that effort is in between the load and fulcrum. So these are the example of third class lever. Similarly, this photograph in which fishing rod held by one person, where effort is applied, where is fulcrum and which thing act like a load, through which we come to know that fishing rod, it is the example of third class lever. Fact, greater is the distance between effort and fulcrum, greater is the load that can be move. See this diagram. Effort and fulcrum. Greater distance, greater is the load that can be moved. See one question, blow your mind. Which class of lever is the human arm? So which class of lever it is? First class. Which one? First class lever. First class of lever. Clear? Some question for the practice up to third class of lever. Define load arm. Second effort arm. Second question, what is a simple machine? Third question, draw a diagram of seesaw, pair of tongs and nut cutter with labeling. Up to this, read the chapter and learn fulcrum, load, effort definition also, and try to draw all the diagrams in rough copy. Thank you.